Hey, sixth grade, Mrs. Toivola here with your help. Help video for 6.4.2. We're talking about compound experiments where two things are done at the same time. So the directions here say spin number one and spin number two. So I'm gonna put a plus there. We have to put both outcomes together. So if you just look at spinner one right now, it's on a W. And if you look at spinner number two, it's on a five. So down here, I need to find a place to put W and 5. Well, I do see it says first spinner outcomes. So if we look at spinner number one, we could have red, blue, white, or green. I know that yours, if you're on paper, is in black and white and gray. That's fine. That's why you can use the letters. All right, so let me check one more time. Red, blue, green, and white. That's the first spinner. And the second spinner doesn't have colors, it has numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So going down the side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so how are we going to fill this in? Looking back again, we said that the first spinner already landed on white and the second spinner landed on 5. So I'm going to find the place where those columns and rows intersect. So here's the W column and here's the number 5. So in that box where they cross, where they intersect, I'm going to write W5. That means on the first spinner it was white, and on the second spinner it was the number 5. But it wouldn't have had to be that. On the second spinner, instead of a 5, it could have been, see, I'm going to make this a little bit skinnier here. It could have landed somewhere else. So I'm going to cover up that arrow on the 5 and say, well, what about if it had landed on 1? Well, now my combination is white and 1. So let's find where that is. Here's white, here's 1, right where they meet, that's W1. All right, you're probably getting the idea here. It wouldn't have had to land on 1. Maybe it would have landed on 3. The first one is still white, so white and 3. W3. All right, so you can see this entire column underneath the W all starts with W because they're all going to be the first spinner lands on white. And the second spinner could have landed on 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Right. Now, what about if the first spinner didn't land on white? If the first spinner didn't land on white, it could have landed on, let's pick green. So green, and looking at the second spinner, 3. So where is green 3? Right, here's my G column. Here's my 3 column. G3. Your job is to fill in this table. You will have an extra column. You don't need this one on the end. There are only 4 outcomes on the first spinner. Right, Ms. Toivola intentionally put too much there. Down on the bottom, you have to list all the possible outcomes. Well, look at this W column. We already have all of them. W1, W2, W3, W4, W5. Here we go. W1, white and a 1. White and a 2. White and a 3. White and a 4. White and a 5. It can't be white 6. Our brains are going to want to do that. But look at the spinner. Is there a 6 on that spinner? No. Then we can't use W6. Ms. Toivola put a lot of tricky spots on here for you. You will have too many numbers as well. Okay, on the backside, probability trees. Brian wants to buy a new bicycle. He can choose a large or a medium bicycle. So here's Brian at the beginning of our tree, needing to make a choice. Choice one is to get a large bicycle. Choice two, looking back at the sentence, is to get a medium bicycle. You don't have to write the entire word, but you can if you want to. If you can make it fit, that's even better. Right? So first he has to decide large or medium. I'm going to say he got a large bike. Next he has to make a decision. Does he want the bike in red, blue, black, or purple? So looking here at the choice, now that he's at large, he could have a red bike. Now that he's at large, he could have blue, but weren't there other choices? Yeah, there was black and purple. So let's write that in. Black and purple. Okay, when you are reading these, you have to have one line going from left to right. So I see that Brian picked large. So where it says outcome, I'm going to write large. And the color he picked is red. He could have had a large bike and picked a different color. He could have picked large and blue. I'm going to caution you to be careful when you are abbreviating things. Blue and black both start with the same letter. Didn't have to be large and blue. It could have been large and, wrong thing, large and black. Your job is to complete this tree diagram, and all possible outcomes are here on the end. I do not have extras for you this time, so there are 8 outcomes. All right, the very last one I am going to read just in case you end up getting a little bit stuck. On Friday, the school cafeteria is serving pizza, hamburger, or chicken. I notice here's pizza, so there's hamburger and there's chicken. You will need to write that in. If you are a student in the cafeteria getting school lunch, first you will have to make one of those choices. Then you need to choose a drink. They are requiring you to take one. It can be white milk, chocolate milk, or juice. White milk, chocolate milk, or juice. Make sure that you fill in this tree diagram and don't forget to check your answers before you turn it in.